So, hello and welcome back to another episode of Hannah Beth's Adventures. Or it's a new series, at least. I don't know, I'm making it up to go along. So, here we are outside the British Museum. This is my lovely friend Charlotte, who's also a YouTuber. Please check her out.
Where are we going, Charlotte?
Egypt!
Yeah! I had this cool idea that we'd jump into each room and show you around, but I kept forgetting to do that. So, here's just some random footage of what we saw in the British Museum, which was absolutely fascinating and free. I love free stuff, and so does Charlotte. Remember to check out her channel. It's all about finding stuff for free and making profits and living your best life. But yeah, aren't museums cool? Isn't it nice to learn all about ancient civilizations that aren't spoken of in the Bible, that are as old as the Bible? Anyway, it blows my mind. I love it. I love learning about it and it excites me. So I hope you enjoy this footage of random stuff. And I kept finding like naked things, lots of, yeah, but anyway, I hope you enjoy. Thanks. Goodbye.
Look at this piece of gold here with a triangle. Is that a hairy vagina? It's even got like the little flaps. I love all the sexual stuff. They are a racy bunch.
Oh, look, being devoured by lions.
And his little gold shorts.
Man in a thicket of stars, lotus.
But can you see like the colours, the details, like gemstones? I wonder if that whole thing would have been covered. The little beads and pretty things.
Wow. The polish.
Do you think of the Ark of the Covenant is real?
I don't know who it is.
Oh, Indiana Jones?
Yeah, but I didn't obviously pay much attention thinking it was just a film.
Oh, like, yeah, it's like a real, apparently a Bible thing.
It's cuneiform writing. Like a little miniature doll's house.
Pretty cat. Oh, what are they doing to the rabbits? They like eating rabbit.
There's the ladies. Oh, look, they've actually carved out her. I wonder if she had a jewel there.
A bejeweled, what they call them? Bejazzle. Oh, more of those headrests.
Oh my God, check out that bang. Is that a bangle, do you think? Oh, those earrings are gorgeous.
Basket woven shoes.
They're not like recreated. Oh no, they might be originals because they're a bit worn at the back. Wow, what a fan. Are these like little toys, do you think? Why does it look so well preserved? They're amazing, aren't they?
Sorry. Hi. I'm just so loving life. The detail is mad. Not really, like I said, kept forgetting to do that bit, but hope you enjoyed the Egypt selection. After we left the museum, we found this amazing garden where this guy was feeding some pigeons, so we asked if we could join him. He agreed, and yeah, it was really lovely end of the trip. So massive thank you for Charlotte for getting this and capturing this beautiful moment.
Goodbye. They fight for position, so they sort of hold on a bit hard sometimes. Lucky poo.
Yeah.
Good name for a pigeon, that actually, lucky poo.
They do say that though, don't they? Mm. Oh, they eat quick. Look how many they've eaten already.
And my favourite one with guitar in my ear. So he sort of snorts at me.
That wood pigeon, his face. It's like, how dare you? How dare you feed them and not me?
Oh, so much outrage. So much outrage. Because they all think they're your favourite and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah,
so these howls of outrage, I guess. shoulder or whatever.
Whee! Off they go.
Like a couple of sort of, well, quite a few slightly injured ones. There's one with just one foot that normally comes to get in bed, which is not really turned up yet today. Keeping an eye on it.
How does it walk?
She hops. Actually, she walks one foot, one stump, actually. Yeah. She sort of adjusted over the last year.
This one's got a bit of
a he's got, he needs a bit of TLC, yeah. Yeah, when something's, when you've got a fresh problem, I don't mind sorting it out, but when it's been, when it's sort of like long established, you can do more harm than good just diving in. But I've got sort of, I've got the antiseptic in the bag.
So you actually treat them?
Yes. Most of them have got gorgeous feet, haven't you?
You've
got lovely feet.
Whoa!
Oh.
I felt that.
Why did they do that?
I don't know.
It must have been like another animal around.
It's often the blackbirds. Wow. They just do it for naughtiness, to scare them off.
So oh, right.
They let out their alarm call.
Am I allowed to throw the seed?
Yeah, sure, sure, do whatever.
I don't want to waste it.
No, 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 it won't get wasted.
You ready, guys?
Oh.
Is it meow!
Wow.
Oh, that's
me.
Reloading,
pigeon hands, whatever. Yeah, I'm vaccinated. Vaccinated and pigeon food.
Oh, good, good, good.
Well, not quite.
Oh, well, thank you for that. That was a nice experience.
There you go. See, I told you this garden was great, didn't I?
Phoenix Garden, your local community wildlife garden.
Right. Is it your garden?
It's, well, I live next to it.
Yeah, cool. Thank you for that. What was your name?
Steve.
Hello,
Steve. I'm Charlotte. Hello. I'll say hello next time when I come and watch the show.
All right.
You see, I saw you a little while ago, and didn't I say there was a man here playing? Feeding pigeons all over him. That's great.
Mm-hmm. I'm full now.
Fabulous. Okay. Well, thank you.
Sorry. Oh, yeah. And having conversation with pigeons, perhaps it's gone too far.
Yeah, you've gone nuts now. Yeah, it's nice though. It's nice. Well, we talk to our animals, don't we? Our dogs and cats and things. It's different. I did work with a lady that had a bird, and I didn't know anyone that had a bird as a pet, but yeah, her relationship with it was amazing.
Yeah, and some of these guys, I mean, some are just feral, but some are really into sort of interactive and friendly, and yes, it is about the food, but they're all, when the food's gone, they'll still come and sit on my shoulder and sort of go, things like that. So it's, yeah. And of course, I've got that genetic, having been domesticated at one stage, there's some sort of like genetic connection somewhere. But we abandoned you, didn't we? Once we've had enough of you.
I felt like we must have got something
there.
It's like you knew it was going
to land. Did you know Tesla?
Yeah.
You know Nikola Tesla? He fell in love with a pigeon.
Did he?
Mm.
I wouldn't be surprised.
And he wanted to marry it.
Eccentric character. Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's...
fond of them. A little bit.
Not
quite.